Hi, welcome in Exerters Training Center. I would like to share with you an observation, which as it emerged during one of the last trainings, it's not entirely clear. Recently, we've talked about drawing the dangerous areas as part of the passage plan. Pay attention to the way in which you define the boundary of no-go area. Take a look at the presented section of the chart, where we clearly see the values of soundings marked in bold. Exit marks in this way all soundings that are equal to or less than the set value of the safety depth. The value of safe depth is calculated using the immersion of our ship, squat value increasing with speed, and margin of safety, which includes such factors as chart accuracy, corrections for list, trim, waves, etc. In short, the safety depth value corresponds to the calculated safe ship's draft. ECDIS will mark the dangerous depth according to the requirements of the IHO, which says that soundings equal to or smaller than the value of safety depth should be more conspicuous than deeper soundings. In practice, soundings shallower and equal to safety depth are bold, or simply black on the chart. On the other hand, soundings deeper than the set safety depth remain gray. We know the rules. Let's draw a no-go area. Looks like everything is fine. The depths considered dangerous were included in the no-go area. The question is, does the accuracy of the chart allow us to prepare a route close to our no-go area? Situation is simple when the soundings are densely arranged. But if there is an area without a clearly marked depth between the safe and dangerous depths, you should stay on the safe side. When marking the dangerous area, we should draw it to the known safe depths. When analyzing screenshots from ships, we can see a tendency to mark no-go areas in the smallest possible region. This can often lead to your ship being exposed to unnecessary risk of grounding. Simply use the good seaman's practice from the time of the paper charts and stay on the safe side. Have a great day. Bye bye.